Welcome friends, I am Tonmoy and welcome you all in my channel, Chemistry, Chemistry of Molecules. So, today we shall discuss about directed aldol reaction. In previous video, I have explained about aldol reaction, basic concept, biogenesis trajectory and cross-aldol condensation. And this directed aldol reaction is an extension of a cross-aldol condensation. And the basic concept of directed aldol is the reversibility of aldol condensation improvised, means how to make this reversible reaction irreversible. So let's start. So in this video, first we will describe the basic concept about the aldol condensation, different ways used in aldol condensation, and the advantage of this reaction and application of this reaction for organic synthesis. So let's start. First of all, you can see this directed aldol condensation. Here the main basic scheme is reaction of an alpha halocarbon, alpha carbonyl with carbonyl having an alpha hydrogen and base to produce this enolate and water. So here if you can see, this pKa of this carbonyl is around 20 to 21, although the pKa of water is 15.7. what does it mean? Means a weak acid is producing a strong acid and it is not feasible thermodynamically. Consequently, the equilibrium remains in left side. Why this reaction proceeds? Because this enolate produced is consumed by reaction with another carbonyl. That's why this reaction proceeds in the front direction. Otherwise, this equilibrium of this state is unfavorable. So, this produced enolate is doesn't stabilize. And what happens? This enolate reacts with another carbonyl. For example, if we take a cross carbon, cross reaction, this is R1, this is R2. These pushes and these attack, and in this way cross-aldol condensation happens. But still the main problem is there, the less concentration of this region. So what could be the solution? One of the potential solution is, let's make this irreversible, this backside equilibrium into the front side. How it could be done? Instead of this OH, we can take a strong base. Strong base means the pKa of the conjugate acid. For example, this is water, pKa is 15.7, lesser than this. That's why the problem. So pKa will be higher than this. One of the example is LDA. You also know lithium diisopropyl amine, LDA. See, LDA is a very strong and bulky base. So this is the structure of LDA with a conjugated pKa of the conjugated acid is 38 compared to 15.7 is water. Another is lithium HMDS, lithium hexamethyl silyl amide. So this is like a LDA, but problem is that it is relatively less basic than this LDA. So this is also used in this reaction, but rarely, because this is more strong, more active. I got this from a paper. I will provide the link of this manuscript in the description. So, okay. So, what happens? This LDA or HMDS, mainly LDA, is used to deprotonate this. And what it does in presence of LDA, this produces the same enolate. So, you can say this with aline. Or actually it will undergo resonance, because actually this is a lithium plus and this carbon ion, so it will undergo resonance to produce this O minus double bond Li plus. Now the question, why Li is preferred? Because lithium has a capability to stabilize this oxygen by a little covalent character compared to other sodium, potassium. Lithium has relatively better covalent character, in this way it stabilizes. And generally you will find that during this reaction, DME is used as solvent. DME means dimethoxyethane. This is. So it can do the chelation to the lithium. In butyl lithium discussion, I have shows you about T-meta. Please go through that. You can have some better idea how this stabilizes. Okay, so I have uploaded the butyl lithium slide. You please see the aggregation of butyl lithium and different reagents. So these coordinates, and after that this lithium enolate produced, it is relatively stabilized. I say relatively because LDA is stronger base, from LDA to relatively weaker base is produced, so this is relatively stabilized. And this could be utilized for the cross-aldol condensation. What do I mean? Previously I have showed this. So it was reacting, right now this can react. This can react and perform the cross-aldol condensation. Another advantage of this method is this enolate could be separated, protected. How? It could be reacted with trimethyl silyl chloride. What do I mean? So trimethyl silyl chloride. What happens? If it reacts with this reagent, this silicon is electron deficient and CCl bond is also not that much stable. So consequently, this O minus attacks here and it leaves. One question you may come that generally when I am doing aldol reaction, I am showing attack is happening from this carbon center, but when silicon is there, I am showing oxygen. Because carbon is soft, so aldol condensation, this is soft, means soft interaction, that's why attack is happening from there. But oxygen is hard center, silicon is also relatively hard center. Second, the produced silicon oxygen bond, what do I mean? This O is Me3, this silicon oxygen bond is stronger. That is the reason for this reaction. How it's stronger? Because this lone pair is back donated to the energetically accessible vacant D or vital of silicon. I repeat, the lone pair of oxygen is back donated to the energetically accessible vacant D or vital of silicon. Consequently, that's why this bond is stable and consequently this reaction process. So this is the basic concept, means that making the irreversible reaction into front direction. So that is the basic concept for this directed aldol condensation reaction. So I will now explain about examples. Okay,
let's continue the discussion about the application of directed aldol condensation using two examples. Okay, let's start. Here you can see LDA. This LDA is act as a base, means very bulky base. So what happens? There is a chance that it can abstract this proton or this proton. But LDA is very strong base and very bulky, and that's why it prefers to abstract this proton. And second point, this proton is more acidic compared to this because of the presence of this methyl group, which is electron donating in nature. Consequently, what happens? That it abstracted and produces anion, and actually means you can say carbonyl or enolate. And this enolate could be remain in this two form. This is enolate, means negative charge on oxygen. And another thing, it should have another canonical form, means this negative charge will come here and here negative charge will be there. So compared to this and this, this is more stable because oxygen is having the negative charge. And another thing, proof of this concept, this enolate could be trapped using trimethyl silyl chloride and it forms this silyl ether. Reason? This silyl ether formed because the silicon oxygen bond energy higher compared to this carbon oxygen bond energy because this lone pair. So consequently this produce this silyl ether. So actually it is trapped. Okay, and here after that tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride, which is generally known as TBAF, what happens? This fluoride attacks this silicon and this bond opens. Open means it comes here and it generated the carbonyl. So why this is open? Because silicon fluorine bond energy is very higher. Similar like this, fluorine has three lone pair and it can push to the silicon center in this way. It can delocalize this electron to the vacant d orbital silicon more stable. Okay, fine. So this indirectly you can say in situ it produces this minus enol. So this can undergo reaction on this carbonyl. Carbon means it's an aldehyde and produces an aldol condensation product. So this is. So in this way, directed aldol would be achieved. Means if you react these two in between, there is a chance of cross this, but using this exclusively, this product could be generated as the negative charge is on here. Okay, fine. So this is the first example. Second example is LDA-DME under same condition. So what will produce this? After that, now question is, means this, here we are adding pH-ACBr. So what will happen if we add pH-ACBr? Now there is a competition, means in case of this oxygen can attack like this silicon, or carbon can attack like this aldol condensation. Now question, which will attack? here carbon will attack because this selenium and this carbon bond is relatively stronger, and like that silicon it is not that much stable. Okay, that's why carbon will attack here. So if this carbon ion, means for example this will attack here and bromide will leave. So what will be the product? Here the product will be this is methyl, this is O, and AC, this is pH. Okay, fine. Now what will happen? You can see first pH-ACBr we have done. So third step is H2O2. And another thing, you can see there is in product it is given. So it is a clue for you which direction you should think. So hydrogen peroxide will oxidize selenium because it's analogous to sulfur, easy to oxidize. So it will oxidize this to this selenoxide. Okay. So hydrogen peroxide will oxidize selenium to selenoxide. So what right now you can see this is oxidized, and under room temperature it can undergo selenocope elimination, or you can say selenoxide elimination. How? And actually keep it in mind, this is a thin elimination. Generally we observe anti-elimination, but this example is an example of, this is the example of thin elimination. So how is it done? This proton, this oxygen abstract, this bond comes here in this way, it comes. So it's an alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound will produce. So what will happen in case of selenium? This is OH selenium. So we have done right or wrong, you can understand from here. Okay, fine. Now you can see this is a less substituted position double bond is formed, which is generally difficult. So that is the uniqueness of this selenocope elimination. So I believe you have understood the directed aldol condensation, and thank you for listening my video. If you like my teaching, please give a like, share this video among your friends so that many people could be benefited from my effort. And finally, please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video we upload. See you in my next video.